What on earth do we have here? Oh my goodness, is this car ugly. I think it was ugly before it got wrecked, to be honest. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have taken on a fun little project. I think a lot of people originally thought this new car I picked up for our collection was going to be a derby car. You know what? At some point, it still could be a derby car if it makes me mad or gives me a reason to. Yeah, then it may be a derby car. But you know what? I think right now you guys are actually looking at a Toyota golf cart, as far as I'm concerned. So let me back up. Let me tell you how we got to this mindset for this vehicle. So with our new property, if you haven't seen our tour or anything we've been dealing with all around here now, we got some distance to cover to get from point A to point B to the backfields, the barn, the buildings. And truth be told, it kills a lot of time when you're walking from building to building, getting parts, moving things around, especially with everything we're doing, working on stuff right now, as far as upkeep and fixing these buildings up. And I've honestly been stealing and grabbing some of our random derby cars and just hopping in them if we have a battery in them and using them to get around the property. And we were talking back and forth like, man, we really need a dedicated farm vehicle. Something we can just keep maintained, something cheap and simple to hop in, take off, and go get stuff done, throw stuff in the trunk, cut weeds when branches come down, all that kind of stuff. Well, I have been looking for a golf cart for probably 2 months. I don't know if you guys have ever tried to shop for a golf cart, but boy, those things are pricey. I have no idea why a golf cart costs so much money. It is just insane. People around here, I don't know around you guys, but around here, if you're wanting a gas golf cart, which is what I want, I don't want electric. I don't want it to go dead on me. I want to hop in it at any time and never have to worry about plugging it back in. So a gas golf cart is anywhere from $1,000 to $2,000. It's a good chunk of money. And even those are not top-notch golf carts. They're very basic. A lot of them are super old. Like, there was one from the 80s that was going for $1,000. It's just nuts around me. So, this little gem popped up for sale for $300. It runs and drives really well, to be honest, as ugly as it looks. And I thought to myself, you know what? That thing's almost the size of some of those golf carts we're seeing online. This is a very tiny car. I'm like, you know what? Forget it. We're going to do it. So we went and bought this $300 car that we're going to now convert into our Toyota golf cart, as I'm going to now call it, for the farm car. This is a 2002 Toyota Echo. It has stupid low miles for being a 2002. I think it's, I don't have the power on to it right now. I think it is 118,000 miles, if I'm guessing correctly. I mean, really low miles for this vehicle. It's super, super clean. No rust anywhere on it. Underneath is just impeccable, clean car all around, before it was wrecked at least. So the story on this thing is it was a young girl's car, I think college girl, and she was driving it one day on the backcountry roads. A rabbit ran out on the road, and wouldn't you know, she swerved to miss the rabbit. And let's just say the rabbit won, because she swerved so hard, this thing flipped upside down into a ditch and rolled into a cornfield. As you can see here, there's still bits and pieces of corn stuck all over this car as we dig through it all. Around here, I think his back tire's got a bunch stuck back in there from them pulling it out. Oh yeah, there's still a bunch of corn jammed up in there. At least the husk from it. This is from the previous harvest. So yeah, it was totaled by their insurance, but the vehicle received no mobility damage to the drivetrain, to the engine. All that's perfectly fine. It's all cosmetic. It's pillar damage, roof damage, windows, etc., stuff like that. So my game plan for this thing is it's a four-cylinder Toyota. It's crazy reliable. It's a timing chain, not a timing belt. I researched that, so we don't have to worry about the belt dry rotting over time. I'm trying to pick a vehicle that's going to be super easy to maintain, small enough to be stored all over the property without taking up much space, but something we can hop in and go anytime we need to take equipment, haul stuff around. Heck, we might even throw a tiny little hitch on this thing and to pull stuff around. We could put a bump guard on the front and the back to push vehicles. We'll raise the suspension up higher so it can go a little bit more off-road through the fields. Switch out some of the tires on it. It's going to be a fun little golf cart, and it is going to be immensely cheaper than an actual golf cart, strangely enough. And unlike golf carts, where if something goes wrong with them, you got to bring them to a specific place to get worked on, this is still a car. So I could bring this to any mechanic shop if I really want to get it worked on, if I don't do the work myself. Of course, we're not going to title it. We're not going to plate it for the road. If I need to get it worked on, I'll just trailer it somewhere and drop it off. But we should be able to keep this thing around for a very long time with the low miles in excellent condition that it was kept previous to now. So what am I working on now and why is it sitting up here? Well, right now I'm actually just trying to waterproof this thing. It's been sitting 2 weeks since I've had it on my property. It's been sitting for probably a month at the towing company where we got it from, where it was totaled out. So it's taken on water. It's starting to dry out now. I've had it in the sun a couple days sitting here. But my project right now is the windows and the windshield. And here's my thought process. So this window has blown out of the driver's door. It's the worst damage. I think when it flipped, it was right here. It hit hard, smacked that, peeled this windshield open, the roof came up. Doors all open and closed though, by the way, as bad as it looks. Everything on these doors is still straight. The frames on the doors are straight. No worries there. It's just everything up here. But you know what? We got sledgehammers and car jacks, so we will fix that good enough and straighten it out. And interior wise, it's actually really clean, good shape. Like I said, it was definitely maintained up until the point they totaled this vehicle. These cars, if you've never sat in them, these little Toyota Echos are very strange to sit in, because when you sit in them, of course, ignore the shattered glass here, your dash is actually center of the car. So your speedometer, your gauges, everything like that, it's all in the center there. It's just weird to me. I'm used to everything being right in front of you. Instead, in front of you is nothing, and you get like these storage trays and everything else that's all underneath here. So quite the setup with how they built this vehicle. Be a little weird to drive. But yeah, I honestly thought about maybe fixing it and putting it back on the road, but there's gonna be a chunk of money involved. And to be honest, I have plenty of other vehicles to drive. So it's gonna be a golf cart. And let me show you what I started on with the back window here. So, you see this here is not the original back window. I've already cut and removed the whole back window. What was left of it was all shattered. There was glass there. We vacuumed this whole car out. Cut all the rubber, cleaned that all up out of here. And this here is clear acrylic or plexiglass, as you guys know by the name brand. It just got the cover on it. But if you look here, that stuff peels off and it's completely clear and see-through. I got decent quality kind. It's UV resistant, crack resistant, shatter resistant, all that fun stuff. And it is way cheaper than going and getting another windshield for the front and back of this car and trying to, you know, put that in myself and not break those or whatever else later on. I want something that can handle some abuse. So that's why we got these sheets over here that I'm cutting shapes out of. And we'll put those in, pretty much my game plan here. I got a bunch of self-tappers, and we're gonna get a bunch of nice, good silicone, some caulk or something to put around this sealant, make it waterproof again. I've already shaped out the back window and the curves. Once it actually fits in place, it will fit. If I can line it up for you guys. I'm doing this with one hand right now. So it's gonna fit right in there, all along the edge here, be completely sealed off, and I will just self-tapper it through all that perimeter where the old one used to be. And that should work out really well. I think it'll be better because we can now hit rocks off of it, branches, other crazy stuff like that, and not have to fear about shattering the glass. Another cool little thing I do like about this car that I hadn't planned until I picked it up is this bad boy still has crank windows. You know what? That means no electricity, no components in these doors, nothing that's going to get ruined from water and rain, mud, anything we take it on back here through the fields. Also means that's one less thing to break and to maintain, because like I said, I want something super easy with no maintenance for my golf cart. And a couple people have suggested that I talk to about actually turning this to a open top golf cart. They talked about, well, just lop off the roof because it's already smashed, open it up, make a little bug screen like you would a normal golf cart. That's tempting, don't get me wrong. It was a cool idea I thought about for a little bit with the glass already being messed up and everything. It made more sense. But I do want something that I can store indoors and outdoors regardless of the weather. That's why I'm making this waterproof again. If I don't have room in the pole barn, in the barns back there, we can just park this wherever we're at. If we need to mess with something out in the middle of the hayfield, whatever the case, we'll do that. It'll work out nice. So there's the first of many vehicles. You guys are getting a chance to look through everything we've been picking up lately in all of our derby cars. Growing our collection, we wanted to go through and buy a bunch for this year right now and then start picking through them to run. Just because we're running so many bone stock shows this year, we have to pick and choose from our collection what makes the most sense per each set of rules. But no, this car should not see the Derby Arena this year. Depending how well it handles as a golf cart will determine its future going forwards. The car did not receive any frame damage from the crash. Probably a few of you are wondering right here. This is just the headlight removed, fender moved a little bit. But frame rails are completely straight. Bumper's completely straight, no dents in it. Radiator's fine. Heck, I'm pretty sure this thing still has air conditioning and all that stuff as well. None of that was damaged. No worries there. So, I don't know, I'm pretty happy with it. Let me open the hood, show you what it looks like underneath here if I can get to it. Windshield wipers need some love. But yeah, there's really not much to these cars. It reminds me, I don't know, is this the exact same setup as a Corolla pretty much? It reminds me a lot of this era of Corollas, these style of engines. It even has your shifter linkage way down there up front, which is a very common thing with the Corollas, and your throttle body and everything right there in the front. And then when you derby them, that's something to watch out for. So yeah, pretty much that's all it is a mini version of a Corolla packed into this little car. So yeah, I'll clean it up, piece it back together. Stay tuned for more updates on this thing. And if I find anything else random that I didn't know broke from the onslaught of the cornfield, I'll let you guys know as we clean this thing up. And stay tuned. It is getting time to start building a few cars as well as we get into the beginning of build season, derby season for us, and where we're going to run these things.